In the last two videos in this series, we looked at attributes of communication and evolution of communication. Let's put these ideas to use while designing a website. A website allows one-to-many communication. In a later video, we will see how we have to consider who is our target audience and what needs of the audience does our website fulfill. A website allows communication over vast distance. Anyone with an internet connection anywhere on the planet can view our website. When it comes to communication over time, we need to consider if our audience needs information to be consumed synchronously or asynchronously. For example, the annual day celebration in our school can be telecast live on the internet for parents, ex-students, and other audience. This is synchronous communication. Information is being produced and being consumed simultaneously. On the other hand, a lecture by a teacher can be recorded and archived on YouTube so that the audience can view it whenever it is convenient for them. This is asynchronous communication. Another aspect that we need to consider while designing a website is if we are pulling our audience to the information or are we pushing the information to the audience. Information that is not going to change over time, like information about the location of our school, its history, past achievements, etc., is called static information. While information like weekly news about events in our school, information that changes often, is called dynamic information. We can put static information on our website and pull our audience. And we can push the dynamic information to our audience using, say, a monthly newsletter that is emailed to all the students and parents. If there is information that needs to be communicated urgently, say early closure of the school due to bad weather, in such situations, we can instantly push the information to the parents using email or SMS. While designing our website, we will keep in mind what type of information needs to be pushed to our audience and what type of information is static, and the audience can come to the information when they need it. Keeping the above consideration in mind, our website can either be a static website or a dynamic website. Think of a school brochure that can be repurposed into a website to elegantly display the contents of the brochure online. In this case, we will design a static website. If the information changes, we will have to redesign the whole web page. But if we want to share the information about events happening in our school every week, our website will need to be updated every week. In such a scenario, creating a static web page that needs to be rebuilt every week will be tedious and time-consuming. Instead, in such a scenario, we will design a dynamic website. To design a dynamic website, we create a front-end, template-based interface for the viewers and a back-end database where the information is updated and stored. We then link the two. Say, for a weekly news web page, we will create a template that has one section to put a photo or a video of the event and another section that contains the short descriptive text about the event. Then we will create a database with tables that have different fields. In this case, we will create a table with two fields, one for the photos or videos and one for the text. By doing so, we won't have to design our news webpage again and again every week. Instead, we will simply update the fields in the table of our database and link the front-end page template to the database such that whenever we put in new information and publish, it automatically gets updated on our webpage. This saves a lot of time, and also all the old posts can be saved automatically to an archive page. Fresh event information is on display on our website, and the user can click a link to view information about past events on the archive page. We will learn to create both static and dynamic websites. To create a static website or web page, we will use the free tool Mobirise. It is available for Windows, Mac, and also as a free app for Android phones and tablets. To create a dynamic website or web page, we will use the free tool WordPress. WordPress can also be used on a PC, Mac, and as an app on Android phones and tablets. The most important attribute to keep in mind while designing a website is that it should not be boring and difficult to navigate for our audience. It should be interesting, engaging, and easy to use. To ensure this, we will use text, photos, videos, and perhaps even animation. We will also look at how to best design the navigation menu for ease of use. What happens if we put an image and a blind person visits our website? How will the information about the photo be conveyed to a blind person? Ensuring that information is accessible to people with disabilities is called universal accessibility. So, for example, we give an alternate text-based description for the photographs and this text description is only available to a visually disabled person using a text-to-speech conversion software. Universal access is another thing we will keep in mind while designing our website. In the next video, we will look at the website design process.